Welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome to a new video of Triple Grace. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And the topic of this video is the strong delusion. And they should believe a lie. Brothers and sisters, let's talk about 2 Thessalonians 2, verse 11. And for this cause, God shall send them strong delusion that they should believe a lie. A lie, brothers and sisters. What kind of a lie? And why is all this necessary? Let me give you the answer right away. It is necessary so that all scriptures will be fulfilled. When we go and have a look at 2 Esther chapter 13, and we see that all the nations will come together to fight against the mountain that is appearing in the sky, what is Mount Zion, at the sixth seal. We know and have understood that chapter so very well. Then there must be a reason why they believe that what is coming is not the Lord, it is not the Father, but it's the enemy. And we know when they believe this, they believe a lie. But how do you bring forth such strong understanding in the world so that they come together to fight against their own salvation, their only salvation that is coming from the sky? So there must be something happening before that gives them that as such a strong delusion. What is it? It all began with the presidency of Ronald Reagan. It all began at that time when he stood, I cannot recall where it was, but he made a speech and he said that when an alien invasion would come, that would be the only way that the whole world would unite. And from there, that plan of strong delusion was put into place, and it was growing, it is growing, it is preparing, it is settling in the minds, it is fostered by the media, so serious like the ancient alien theories and everything like that, telling you that a time will come when ancient astronauts, when people from other planets will come and say, yes, we are your ancestors. We are the good people. We are coming to help you. If you know the series Visa Visitors, then you know how it could happen. But also understand that they are just demons in disguise. They have harvested DNA strains from this earth to make them look alike, a perfect match, so that they can then claim, look, we are like you, but we are higher advanced. We have other possibilities. We can do miracles and wonders here on earth through the power of Satan. And Satan is the rightful heir to the throne. They will claim to come from the Pleiades. They will claim to come from other planets to say, yes, from there we came and seated you here on the earth. Brothers and sisters, do not give in to this strong delusion. Do not believe the lie. Because this will happen during the sealed tribulation. And once the world has accepted them as the ancestors, and they come with a lot of gifts. They will come with healing things, they will come with miracles, they will raise people from the dead, most likely, if they can. I do not know exactly if that would be possible. But they will do something to show great wonders and miracles, fake ones here on earth. And the main ruler will be Mr. O as the Antichrist for the worldly empires. So once the world has then accepted that these are the good guys, then an event will take place. And that event is, you will see suddenly, maybe what people call right now Planet X or Nibiru or whatever, you see the mountain coming from the sky. And so the world will be afraid. And this fake ancestors will say, look, we are the good one. Have we not helped you all the time? We have brought together with the Antichrist order out of chaos. Now these people who are coming are the bad ones. So let us all stand together and fight against them. And so it will come to 2 Esther chapter 13, the war against the mountain. Because the world will be coming under a strong delusion and they will believe the lie. The lie that the ancestors are coming from other planets. And the reality, they are accepting demonic spirits into their houses, into their hearts, into their minds, and even into their souls, and then they will be damned. Do not fall for this strong delusion. It is coming. They are coming. They are coming so very soon. They are not coming during the 40 days when Jesus is on earth. Also, the world will reject him as the Antichrist, but then they will realize he is not. But then, once the power will be given to the two Antichrists, they will appear. A full disclosure will be done and they will be here, walking amongst us. But they are not, they are much more than only wolves in sheep's clothing. They are reptilians covered with human skin. As you see it in that movie, The Visitors. And they are coming to enslave you and to harvest you and to bond you forever. And to make their master, Satan, the ruler over the whole earth, and then from there they will attack the heavens so that he can sit on the throne of the Father. This strong delusion will come, and it's already on the way. They're already prepared. These movies are not science fiction when you will see motherships appearing in the sky. They will come. You are prepared for that. You must understand that you are prepared for that. And also the Father have given you understanding that these people will be fake. But still the world will believe them because they will come in with flattery. They will come in with gifts. They will come in with healing. They will come in with cures, maybe for cancer and for everything what you could not heal before. How can they do that? Because Satan has access to the heavens and also has access to healing technology. Brothers and sisters, do not fall for that delusion. They are not your ancestors. They are not the heavenly beings that they claim to be. They are the bad ones, the demonic forces. This strong delusion will come over the whole earth. And this can only fall after the people have all received the toxin so that they can be put into one mind, mind control. And when you have the minds connected together, one mind of New Egypt, then you can bring in that delusion. Then you can build it up very strongly. And when then the fake aliens are coming, then the world will accept them and embrace them. You know, they are not coming with war. They are not coming to fight you. They are coming to bring you help. In a similar way as most likely when the US will have their Babylonian time, when Babylon will fall, when natural disasters destroy the land, then also foreign troops will come in disguise of helping. Chinese, Russians, they will come in with food supplies, with medical things to help. And once they are inside, then they can snatch you. And the same will be happen with the aliens. Once they are here, then they can spread, they can take over control over the every world ruler. And once that is done, then Satan has fulfilled his goal and he has you all under control. But we know that God is merciful. We know, yes, he will send great delusion. Yes, many people will believe the lie, but he will also send the remedy. There is new Zion. There are the people who are coming to set you free from that matrix. There are the people who will come to your door and tell you, you have to make a decision now. Let's go. Let's go out in the great exodus, out of New Egypt towards the holy mountain. And many, many will be rescued. And it doesn't matter if you have then taken the vax, because you will be rescued Nonetheless, if you accept the truth and if you walk the path towards the kingdom of heaven, and if you set yourself free from the world, Babylon, and the churches, so that you can come out of that delusion and that you realize that you have believed a lie. 2 Thessalonians 2:11. Brothers and sisters, they are coming, and we have to be prepared for that. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, then Google that subject and you will find so many good or bad videos about it. But you will find a lot of information that will tell you what is going to happen. And it has to come to pass because of 2 Esther chapter 13. Because that war, where the nations are coming together, they will give up their own regional wars and they all come together to fight that mountain. Because the fake ancestors, the fake aliens would have told you what is coming there as is the enemy. But in reality, that is the only salvation that you have. So it will come to that, what Ronald Reagan has said so many years ago, that all the nations will unite against what they called, in brackets, the common enemy. But that is the return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the Father on the throne with Mount Zion for the rest to come. Many are called, but few are chosen. Are you chosen to stand in New Zion against the evil flood, against that strong delusion, to oppose the lie and to set the captives free? If so, then take it to the Lord and tell him that you want to volunteer to be a harvesting bride, a harvest worker for such a time as this. We need more workers. Let us all come forth. The harvest fields are huge. The whole world must be harvested in just only 2.5 to 3 years before Antichrist has reached full power. The time is short. The strong delusion is coming, and what you see with the toxin is a preparation for that, so that there is mind control in New Egypt, so that the people can then be controlled and the strong delusion can be put in their minds. And then you will even see the fiercest reptilian as your friend. All was shown to you so many years ago. Started with the Matrix, you have V the Visitor, you have all these movies where you see all this coming together. Why don't you see the truth? I Am the Legend is another one about the toxin in your body, what it will do to you. It was all shown to you, but you reject it as fantasy, you reject it as something that a crazy mind has developed. No. It is all the plan, a long time plan from ancient time to enslave and bond you in New Egypt. And you're going for it for free. You are making yourself subject to it. You're accepting it and saying, yes, this is your salvation ticket. No, it is not. It is your way to the lake of fire. Also, we know that the toxin is not the mark of the beast, but still it is a preparation for that strong delusion, so that you will believe a lie. Be careful, brothers and sisters. Be careful. Choose life over death. Be part of New Zion. Don't be in New Egypt and then you need rescue. Then you need people to come to you, to help you, to come out. Don't be new. Don't stand in the world anymore. Don't be connected to self-righteous churches or denominations who have no clue what they're reading in the Bible. They have made it a religion, but Jesus was never about a religion. It was always about the kingdom of God, and it was always about the rightful heir to the throne. It was always about the seed wars that started in Genesis 3, verse 15. So come out of her. Join the forces that will stand against the strong delusion and the lie. Join the remnant army of New Zion. You still have time to volunteer. Brothers and sisters, be blessed. Be blessed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Maranatha.